Online, the benefits of captions extend beyond accessibility to the deaf and hard of hearing audience. Search engines like Google use the text-based information in captions to find, quantify, and deliver video content to a potential audience of billions. Ensuring your video shows up in the most relevant searches is called search engine optimization, or SEO. And the flip side of this is if your videos don't have captions, or worse, have captions that are not accurate and relevant to your content, your videos will be passed over. YouTube, arguably the biggest video streaming service on the web, offers a variety of tools for creating and editing captions. And with a little work, you can make sure that your content will show up in relevant internet searches, as well as being fully accessible to your audience. So now let's take a look at YouTube's captioning here. So we go into the subtitles closed caption button, make sure that's turned on. If we go into settings, we can see that YouTube has automatically generated some English captions for us. Now this is done through speech-to-text technology, and for videos that have clear dialogue that's free of background noise, heavy accents, or over-talking, this can really speed up the captioning process. One thing to keep in mind, however, is to never take the automated captions for granted. Speech-to-text technology is good, but it's not perfect. In fact, one of the weakest areas for speech-to-text is getting proper names, jargon, or technical terms right. This is crucial because if the names of people, places, brands, or concepts in your video are rendered wrong, neither a search engine nor a viewer relying on captions will be able to make sense of your video. Speech-to-text is also limited to, well, speech. Any sound effects, nonverbal expressions, or music cues required for effective captioning will be needed to add in manually. So let's take a look at the automated captions that YouTube has created for us on this video.
I spent 30 years of my life as a broadcast journalist, and I covered a lot of the biggest stories of our generation. I covered Hurricane Katrina, I covered the Gulf oil.
So one of the first things you'll notice is that the automated captions don't have any punctuation in them. That can get a little bit confusing, especially for long videos. And also some of the capitalization is off. So Iraq war should be capitalized there. So let's continue on.
The Arab Spring, I figure I've spent thousands of hours of my life transcribing my own interviews, news conferences, speeches, lectures. It's just what every reporter has to do if you're going to write a story. There's no shortcuts clacking in the TV newsroom that we would have the kind of technology we have today, and nobody would have believed it possible. Trint allows you to use our...
Okay, and there it is there. So he said Trint, the name of his company, but speech-to-text engine, register that as print. So somebody looking for Trint, the company, on the internet wouldn't be able to see this video. And somebody watching this video wouldn't be able to know the name of the company that they were looking for if they wanted some more information.
Artificial intelligence to do the heavy lifting, to actually change the way you extract content. What's extraordinary about Trint and what we've always known...
And here again, he said Trint and speech-to-text rendered it as Trenton. So the speech-to-text captions are good, but they're not perfect. And where it's not perfect is important because the company name didn't appear in the captions in this video at all. So luckily, YouTube offers us tools that will let us easily edit our captions and make them more useful. So let's clean this up and correct our captions. Okay, so to do that, we go into the subtitles CC editing options. And we can see here the captions we were looking at were the English automatic captions. So we'll click on those, and we'll just edit the captions that YouTube created. Now what you'll see here is we've got a window on this side, on the left, that has an in time and an out time and the caption content. And then down here, we've got a timeline that shows us the caption and where it shows in regards to the length of the video, and then we've got some audio waveform down here. So let's just go through and fix some spots that we noticed were off with the captions. There should be a comma there. In the Iraq War, actually should be a comma there. And period there. And then when we click on a caption, it brings us to where that is in the video. It's listing off things that he's captioned there. That he's transcribed there. So we'll just put commas in to clear that up a little bit. Period there. Capitalize there. And then the most important things that we found. There we go. So that's where it said we can hear him.
Trent allows you to use.
See, he says Trent, it said print, so let's fix that. And then where he said
about Trenton, what we've always.
So it said Trenton, so he said Trent and, so let's fix that. All right, so I'm going to fix the other little mistakes in here, the punctuation, capitalizations, and that sort of thing. And then we'll take a look at the clean captions when I'm done. All right, so I've cleaned up the captions. And now let's go into the settings cog here. And now we've got two caption files. We've got the auto-generated, which we're not going to use, and the English, which is our corrected one. So now let's take a look at our corrected captions.
I spent 30 years of my life as a broadcast journalist, and I covered a lot of the biggest stories of our generation. I covered Hurricane Katrina, I covered the Gulf oil spill, the Iraq war. Trent allows you to use artificial intelligence to do the heavy lifting, to actually change the way you extract content. What's extraordinary about Trent, and what we've always known is its potential, is to make video content searchable and accessible. And for visually impaired people, while it's true that they can listen to what's been recorded, they can't search it, and they can't search within it. Trent can solve both of those problems very quickly at very low cost.
All right, so we can see that the captions now have proper punctuation. Words that were missed or picked up wrong by the speech to text were corrected. The company name is in there where it should be. And we now have captions that are understandable, accurate, and searchable. Now another bonus of creating our captions on YouTube is that we can download these caption files and use on other social media sites or with other media players. So we're back here in our Manage Subtitles and Closed Captions page. So the English automatic, what I would do is unpublish that so people coming to our video on YouTube won't see the automatic captions. They would only see our edited ones. And those are the English ones. Now, let's say we want to caption the same video on Facebook. So what we need to know first about Facebook is that they use SRT files, and there's a specific naming convention. So not only do you need the name of the file, but also the language code and the country code. So we go down here to the Englishes. We see there's no English Canada, so I'll just use EN underscore US in the file name. So we'll go here. We want to download in SRT format. Save the file. And then we'll go to downloads just to make sure that that's the proper file name. So it's captions SRT. What we want to do is name that captions.en underscore us.srt. And now the caption file we created using YouTube can be uploaded to Facebook. So we're going to upload our video. Got that in the media folder. That was an interview with Jeff Kaufman. And that's uploading. And now I go to captions. And I want to upload an SRT file. I had that in my downloads folder, captions ENUS SRT. Open that. Select the default language is English. Okay, our video file has been uploaded to Facebook. The SRT file has been attached to it. We'll just go to the cog icon here, make sure captions is checked, and we'll take a look.
I spent 30 years of my life as a broadcast journalist, and I covered a lot of the biggest stories of our generation. I covered Hurricane Katrina, I covered the Gulf oil spill, the Iraq war, the Arab Spring.
All right, now we have a caption video on Facebook. So the same process can be repeated to caption videos on other social media, streaming, or blog sites. And now all of your video material can be captioned and made accessible to the widest possible audience.